Students, good evening all. So today we'll have a discussion which is related to algebra. So in algebra, we'll try to understand how the different types of questions are given. So I'm starting with a very basic module, the first module, questions which are related to logarithms. How the questions on logarithms are given, how can we tackle those questions, we'll try to understand. Before we are proceeding with the questions which are related to logarithms, first let me give you the basic definition of logarithm. So what is the basic definition of logarithms if you observe? So logarithms basic definition is, logarithm basic definition is, if y is equal to b power x, then log y to the base b is equal to x, log y to the base b is equal to x. This is a basic definition of logarithms. So we'll try to understand this definition clearly. For example, if we have 10 square, what is 10 square? 10 square is equal to 100. So if you observe, if you apply logarithm, log 100 to the base 10 will be equal to 2. That's the meaning of logarithm, and that's the meaning or basic definition of logarithm. So if y is equal to a power x, so if you apply logarithm, log y to the base b will be equal to x. Log y to the base b will be equal to x. Similarly, for example, if I take 10 cube, what is 10 cube value? 10 cube is going to be 1000. 10 cube is going to be 1000. If you observe, apply logarithm, log 1000 to the base 10 will be equal to 3. That's a basic definition of logarithm. All the questions of logarithms we are going to deal with base 10. Always logarithm is going to have two parts. For example, if you take any logarithm value, so let's take an example as, what is log 2? I'm trying to check out. So log 2 is equal to 0.3010. So you don't need to by heart this value. So I'm just trying to tell you log 2 value is equal to 0.3010. So here, this after decimal, whatever is the value is there, that value we call it as mantissa. Before the decimal, whatever is the value is there, this is called characteristic. So characteristic and mantissa. So the characteristic value is always going to be one less than the number of digits which are available in the given So that means, for example, here we have taken log 2. So how many digits are there in this number? In this number we have one digit. So the characteristic value will be one less than one digit. That's why 1 minus 1, the characteristic will start with 0 point something. So for example, if I'm trying to check out what is log 15 value. So log 15 will be 1.1761. So just to understand the point which I have mentioned here. So how many digits are there in 15? We have two digits here. So characteristic will start with 1 point something. So similarly, if I have any value as log 250. So how many digits are there in 250? In 250, we have three digits. So your characteristic will start with 2 point something. So if you have four digits, so then your characteristic will start with 3 point something. So that's a point which you have to understand. So that's the reason if you observe this log 100 value. So log 100 to the base 10, what is the value? It will be 2. So 2, why it is going to be 2? So because we can write this as log 10 square to the base 10. So this we can write it as 2 log 10 to the base 10. This we can take it as 2. So why it is 2? Because the number of digits which are available here is going to be 3. The characteristic will start with 2 point something. So here it is going to be 2. So not only log 100, so you go till log 999 to the base 10. So this value is also going to start with 2 point something only. So if this value is also going to start with 2 point something. So if you go for log 1000, now 1000 is going to be a 4 digit number. So your characteristic will start with 3. So that's a point which I want to convey. So characteristic value is always going to be 1 less than the number of digits which are available in the given number. 1 less than the number of digits which are available in the given number. So given number is a 3 digit number, characteristic will start with 2 point something. So coming to the properties which you have to remember. So very basic properties which you are very well aware of. So you just need to remember these 5 properties so that you can feel very comfortable. So for example, log xy is here. What is log xy? Log xy is given as log x plus log y. Log x plus log y. So log x by y is there. Log x by y. Log x by y will be given as log x minus log y. Log x minus log y. And log x to the base x. Anything log x to the base x, the value is going to be 1. So similarly, log x power n will be equal to n log x. Log x power n will be equal to n log x. So these are the basic 4 properties. And similarly, log x to the base a will be given as log x divided by log. So these basic formulas, 5 properties, you can keep it in mind. Property number 1, if it is in product, the value will be in terms of summation. Log xy will be equal to log x plus log y. If it is in division, log x minus log y will be equal to log x. Log x by y is equal to log x minus log y. So log anything to the same number will be equal to 1. Log 10 to the base 10 will be 1. Log 100 to the base 100 will be 1. Log x to the base x is equal to 1. Log x power n will be equal to n log x. So the power will come to the quotient, n log x. Log x by log y. Log x by log x to the base a will be given as log x divided by log e. So these are the basic points. You just keep it in mind before we are proceeding with the solution of the question. So let's start with the discussion of the questions which are related to logarithms. So logarithms is one of the important chapter. In AMCAT, we are going to have good number of questions from the logarithms. So let's start with the questions which are available under logarithm. Look at the first question which is available on the screen. So the question which is projected here is simplify 3 log 2 plus 2 log 3. 3 log 2 plus 2 log 3. So 3 log 2. So I have mentioned a point, log x power n will be equal to n log x. So here 3 log 2 will be given as log 2. 2 log 3 will be given as log 3 power 2. 2 cube is nothing but 8. This is log 8 plus log 9. Log 8 plus log 9. So log 8 plus log 9 will be log 8 into 9. 8 into 9 is 72. We can say answer choice is option A, log 72. Answer choice is option A, log 72. Because log x plus log y will be given as log x only. Log x plus log y will be given as log x y. Look at the next question available on the screen. The question here is simplify log 2 to the base 4 plus log 4 to the base 32. So we are able to see this is log 2 to the base 4 plus log 32 to the base 4. So log A plus log B will be given as log AB. So 2 into 32 is going to be 64. We can write log 64 to the base 4. So we can write this as log 4 cube to the base 4. So this is 3 log 4 to the base 4. So log 4 to the base 4 is nothing but 1. So answer choice is going to be 3. Mark it as option E. Look at the next question available on the screen. If a power x is equal to b power y, then what is the relation which we can able to extend? So a power x is equal to b power y. If you apply logarithm on the both sides, then we can write x log a is equal to y log b. So how I am writing? So if you observe logarithm, if you apply, what is the equation we are going to get? Log a power x and log b power y. This is a equation we are going to. Log a power x will be given as x log a. Log b power y will be given as y log. So from this data, so we can write x by y will be equal to log b divided by log a. So here, what is the relation which we can able to see? Log a by log b is equal to y by x, which is available as option C. You can mark it as answer. Log a by log b will be equal to y by x. Log b by log a is y by x by y means log a by log b will be equal to y by x. Mark it as option C. Look at the next question available on the screen. So this is log 27 to the base 9 minus log 9 to the base 27. So if you observe log 27 to the base 9. So how can we write this? So I'm writing this log 27 to the base 9. I'm writing it as log 9 into 3 to the base 9. So we can write this as log 9 to the base 9 plus log 3 to the base 9. Why? Because a into b will be a plus b. So log 9 to the base 9 is anyways going to be 1. So if you observe this number carefully, log 9 to the base 3 will be equal to how much? 9 can be written as 3 squared. This is 2 log 3 base 3, that is going to be 2. So log 3 to the base 9 will be simply reciprocal of that. That is 1 by 2. So what is 1 plus 1 by 2? It is going to be 3 by 2. So this value, we are getting it as 3 by 2. That means this value we are going to get what? 2 by 2. What is LCM of this number? 6. 3 into 3 is 9. 2 into 3 is going to be 6. So we are going to get a result as 5 by 6, which is available as option B. Mark it as a. Look at the next question, which is available on the screen. So question which is projected as like this, log 2 to the base 10 is equal to this. What is the value of log 80 to the base 10? So if you observe log 80 to the base 10, how can we write this? So I'm writing this as log 8 into 10 to the base 10. So log 8 into 10, we can write it as log 8 to the base 10, log 8 to the base 10 plus log 10 to the base 10. Log 10 to the base 10 is anyways going to be 1. 1 plus log 8 to the base 10. So log 8 we can write it as 2 cube. So we can write this as 1 plus 3 log 2 to the base 10. What is log 2 value? 0.3010. So 3 times of this will be given as a result as going to be 0.9030. 1 plus 0.9030 will give a result as 1.9030, which is available as option B. You can mark it as answer. Very simple, just use the data, you'll be able to arrive at it. Look at the next question available on the screen. So if you observe, apply logarithm, log of 2 power 64 is how much? Log of 2 power 64 will be equal to 64 log 2 to the base. So log 2 value is already given. So what is log 2 value? 0.3010. So if you multiply with 64, what is the overall resultant? So if you can multiply, 64 into 0.3010. 64 into 0.3010, that will give the answer. But actually they are asking the number of digits in 2 power 64. So how we are going to get the number of digits in 2 power 64 here? So the number of digits in 2 power 64, I already told you one point, whatever the number you are taking, whatever the number you are taking. So if I'm trying to find out log 2 value, that is 0 point. So number of digits in 2 is 1, the characteristic will start with 0 point something. So here also I'm just trying to find out what is this cumulative value. So if you observe, 64 into 0.3010 will give us a result which is going to be 19.264. I told you a point, the log 2 value will be equal to 0.3010. Similarly, if I find out log 100 value, that is going to be 2. So I realized a point, the number of digits which are available in the number is 1. Characteristic will start with 0 point something. Number of digits will be 3. Characteristic will start with 2 point something. So here the value of so and so number is 19. What is the number of digits which are available in this? Number of digits which are available will be 1 more than the characteristic. So it is going to have 20 digits. Mark your answer choices option C. Mark your answer choices option C. I hope the point is clear. So that's how you can able to see the questions which are related to logarithms. One more practice question available on the screen. Look at this question, try to tell me the answer. Let's observe the data carefully. Log 5 to the base 10 plus log 5x plus 1 to the base 10 is equal to log x plus 5 to the base 10. And what is 1 log 10 to the base 10? 1 is nothing but log 10 to the base 10. To make it same, I am writing like this. Log a plus log b will be log ab. So we can write this as log 5 into 5x plus 1. To the base 10 will be equal to log x plus 5 into 10, 10 times of x plus 5 into base 10. So if you equate these two, 5 into 5x plus 1 should be equal to 10 into x plus 5. So 5 ones are 5 twos are, so 5x plus 1 is equal to 2x plus 10. From this data, 3x will be equal to 9, x will be equal to 10. Mark your answer as option B. Look at the next questions or next chapter, which is related to algebra. That's nothing but we are going to have a questions which are related to functions. Functions is a very simple chapter. You are going to have funky function based or basic substitution based questions here. If you are aware of basic plugin strategy, you can able to solve these questions easily. Let's start with a very simple question which is available on the screen. Read the following data carefully. x dollar y is nothing but x square minus y. X dash y will be equal to x by y. X star y will be equal to x plus y. They define these symbols as like this. So they are expecting us to find out, determine the value of it. 3 star 5. What is 3 star 5? So x star y is equal to x plus y. 3 star 5 will be 3 plus 5. That will be h. 3 plus 5, that will be h. And look at the other part. So 64 dash 8. So what is 68 dollar 4? Dollar indicates what? That is nothing but x square minus y square. This is 64 minus 16. 64 minus 16. What is 64 minus 16? That is 48. So 48 by 8 is equal. That is going to be 6. Mark it as option A. Look at the next question. That's a simple data. Look at the next question. Look at this, tell me the answer. Read the following information. F of t, g of t, h of t is given. They are asking us to find out f of h of g of when t is minus 2. When t is minus 2. So what is g of t? G of t is going to be 2. So whether it is minus 2 or anything, it will be 2. So what is h of 2? H of 2 is nothing but h of t is minus 2 power t power 3. So this is minus 2 power 3. That is going to be minus 8. So because this is minus 8, f of minus 8 is required. F of minus 8 is nothing but 64 minus 1. That is giving a result as 63. Mark it as option C. Look at the next question available on the screen. So P of X is given, P of 1 is given, P of 2 is given. Determine the value of P of minus 2 when P of 0 is going to be 3. So P of 0 is already given as 3. So if you substitute 0 here, so then we can write p of 0 will be equal to p of minus 2 minus p of minus 1. So p of minus 2 value is required for us. So p of minus 2 is going to be p of 0 plus p of minus 1. So in order to find out p of minus 1, what I am trying to do, so here from this p of minus 2 will be given as p of 0 plus p of minus 1. So in this p of minus 1 is required for me. So in order to get p of minus 1, what I am trying to do is I am trying to plug x is equal to 1. So if I plug x is equal to 1, p of 1 is equal to p of minus 1 minus p of 0. So p of 1 we know it as 0, p of minus 0 is going to be 3. So from this we will be getting p of minus 1. So that is going to be how much? So from this p of minus 1 will be equal to 3. Once you know this is 3, you can substitute here. This is 3 and p of 0 is also going to be 3. So 3 plus 3 is going to be 6, mark it as option A. 3 plus 3 is going to be 6, mark it as option A. Look at the next question. So read the following information. R of a comma b is indicating remainder when a is divided by b. Q of a comma b is indicating quotient when a is divided by b. S of a is equal to root a. So we have to find out this value. So S of 100 is nothing but root 10, root 100, that's nothing but 10. Remainder when 23 is divided by 9 is going to be 5. By 5 is going to be 2. Mark it as option B. Look at the next question. P of A, Q of A, R of A is given. So P of 1. So P of 1 is nothing but. So P of 1 is nothing but 1 cube. So what is P of 1? Again, it is going to be 1. Q of R of 2. So R of 2 is nothing but 2 plus 1. That is going to be 3. Q of 3 is how much? 3 times of 3 square. So 3 times of 3 square is nothing but that is 27 plus R of P of 2. P of 2 is nothing but 2 cube is 8. R of 8 is required. R of 8 is nothing but 9. So basically, this is required for us. So what is this value? Minus 26 plus 9. So minus 26 plus 9 is nothing but. So we are going to get a result which is equal to minus 17. Mark your answer as option. Look at the next question. Look at the question which is available. F of m comma n comma o is nothing but m plus m plus o. So that means 5 plus 3 plus 8. This is going to be how much? It will be equal to 14. Plus g of 1, 2, 3. So what is g of 1, 2, 3? 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. How much it is? Going to be 10 plus 4, 14. Minus h of 5, 6, 7. So 5 into 6 is going to be 30. 30 into 7 is going to be 210. So this is a value. So plus 28 minus 210. So this you can further simplify. You are going to get a result minus 182, which is available as option A. Mark it as an answer choice. That's how you can able to see the questions which are related to functions. Let's look at how the questions of quadratic equations are given. So quadratic equations questions are very simple. So you can observe x plus 3 whole square is equal to 225. Which of the following could be the value of x minus 1? So whenever you have any quadratic equation, you are going to have two roots. So x plus 3 whole square will be equal to 225 will indicate that x plus 3 value will be equal to 15 or minus 15. So from this data, x will be equal to either 12 or x will be equal to minus 18. So they are asking x minus 1 value. X minus 1 will be equal to 12 minus 1, 11, or minus 18 minus 1, that's going to be minus 9. So they are asking us to find out what is x minus 1, that's going to be minus 19. Mark it as option D. Because 11 is not available, you can ignore it. Go for the answer choice as option D. So basically, we use it to do one common mistake. What is the common mistake? Whenever a square is equal to 4, what is a value? A value is not only 2, it will be minus 2 also. Do remember that. Whenever we have a quadratic equation, it will have two solutions. So do remember that one. Look at the next question available on the screen. This is a value given. They are expecting us to find out this value. So 3t cube minus 7 will be equal to 74. So 3t cube will be equal to how much? 3t cube will be equal to 81. So from this, t cube will be equal to 27. From this, t will be equal to 3. So they are asking this value. 3 square is 9. 9 minus 3 is going to be 6. Mark it as option C. Look at the next question available on the screen. So they are asking h plus k by, so we can easily find out. So just observe, what is this? 2h is equal to 4k. So from this, h is equal to 2k. So we can just substitute that here. So k is equal to 2k minus 3. From this data, k is equal to 3. So once you know that k is equal to 3, h value will be equal to 2k. That will be, h will be equal to 6. So h plus k is required. That will be equal to 3 plus 6. That will be equal to 9. Mark it as 9. Mark the answer choices 9. So look at the next one. X minus y is given, x plus y is given. They're asking us to find out x square minus y square. What is x square minus y square? That is x plus y into x minus y. So that means root 12 into root 3. That is root over 36. That is 6. Mark your answer as option B. Look at the next question. So 2a is equal to 4b is equal to 8c is equal to 10. They are asking us to find out 64abc value. 64abc value. So you can just observe these numbers once again. So 2a into 4b into 8c. What is this value? 2 into 8 is 2 into 4. 2 into 4 is 8. 8 into 8 is 64. See, this is 64abc. What is 2a value? 2a value is going to be 10. 4b is also 10. 8c is also 10. 10 into 10 into 10. That is giving a result as 10 cubed. That is 1000. Mark your answer as option. Mark your answer as option E. Look at the next question. What is the value of k? It is having equal roots. Equal roots means what? Discriminant value is 0. Discriminant is what? B square minus 4ac is 0. So whenever you are able to see any quadratic equation as ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, the roots are going to be equal when we have discriminant as 0. Roots are going to be real and distinct when we have discriminant as more than 0. So here, what is the value of a? A is 2k, b is 5k, c is 2. So b square is nothing but 25k square minus 4 times ac. So a is nothing but 2k, c is nothing but 2. This must be equal to c. So 25k square is equal to, we can say 4 into 2 is 8, 8 into 2 is 16, is equal to 16k. 1k is gets cancelled, k is equal to 16 by 25. You can mark the answer as option C for us. So that's all you can able to see the quadratic equation questions. So look at one more. Alpha beta are the roots of the equation. X square minus 6x plus 8. So when we have our alpha beta are the roots of the equation, x square minus 6x plus 8 is equal to 0. So 8 can be written as 4 into 2. So we can write what is alpha beta values here. So 4 into 2 means minus 4x minus 2x plus 8 is equal to 0. From this x, if you take out as a common factor, x minus 4, 2 if you take it as a common factor, x is equal to 4, x is equal to 2. That means alpha is equal to 4 and beta is equal to 2. So they are asking the value of this. What is the equation where alpha beta plus alpha, alpha beta plus beta. So alpha beta is nothing but 4 into 2, h. And alpha is nothing but 4. So 8 plus 4, 12. And alpha beta is nothing but 8, beta is nothing but 2. So 10 comma 12 are going to be the roots. What is the equation of it? So x square minus sum of the roots. So sum of the roots is nothing but 22. X plus product of the roots plus 120 is equal to 0. That's the equation. Or otherwise, you can frame the equation as like this. These are the roots. So we can write x minus 12 into x minus 10 is equal to 0. If you further simplify this, you are going to get this. That is available as option B for us. Mark it as answer. So that's how we can able to see the questions which are related to that. X plus 3, x plus y is given, x square minus, x square plus y square is given. They are asking what is 2xy. So x plus y is equal to minus 3. So if you do squaring on both sides, then we can write x square plus y square plus 2xy will be equal to how much? 9. So x square plus y square is given as 12. So 12 plus 2xy will be equal to 9. So 2xy value will be equal to 3. Minus 3. So they are asking what is 2xy value. That's going to be minus 3. Mark it as answers. Look at the next one. So these questions are basically based on the formula. So a square minus b square is equal to 20z. What is the value of z is the question. So a square minus b square, you can just observe a square minus b square will be given as a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b. So we are able to see these numbers 64 minus 36, a square minus b square. So a square minus b square is given with the formula as a minus b into a plus b. So a plus b is nothing but 64 plus 36, that is 100. What is a minus b? 64 minus 36. 64 minus 36. That is giving a result which is equal to 28. So 28 into 100 will be equal to 26. So 0, 0 cancel, 2 1s are 240s. So what is the z value is the question. Z is going to be 140, which is not available. Mark your answer as none of you. Mark your answer as none of you. Look at the next one, which is available. So the question which is trying to project it as like this. A plus B. So you just look at this as some variable. So replace with some variable so that you can understand the point which is available. So you can just observe 786 plus 123 whole square. So this is in the form of A plus B whole square plus A minus B whole square divided by A square plus B square divided by A square plus B square. So what is A plus B whole square? A square plus B square plus 2AB. A minus B whole square is A square plus B square minus 2A. So these two will be gets cancelled. 2 times of A square plus B square is A square plus B square. So what is the value of it? It's whatever the value of A and B, it always gives a value which is equal to 2. Mark it as such. Look at the next question. Next question is in the form of 4.56 whole cube plus 5.44 whole cube. So it is in the form of a cube plus b cube. A cube plus b cube divided by how much? A square minus ab plus b square. So you can just observe this number. You can just observe this number. How can we write a cube plus b cube? A cube plus b cube will be given as a cube plus b cube will be given as a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. Already denominator is that you can get cancelled with this a square minus ab plus b square. We left with a plus b. A value is 4.56, b value is 5.44. Sum of this is 10. Mark it as such. Look at the next question available on the screen. A cube minus b cube is in the pattern in the numerator. Denominator is a square plus ab plus b square. How can we write a cube minus b cube? It is a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. The denominator is going to be a square plus ab plus b square. These two will be gets cancelled. You are going to get the result as a minus b. What is a minus b? 6.73 minus 1.73. That will give the result as 5. Mark it as option B. So that's how you can able to see the questions. And exponents questions also given. Exponents questions are very simple. Can observe 3 square into 9 square is equal to 3 power x. What is x1? So what is 9 square? Can I write it as 3 power 4? 3 square into 3 power 4 is equal to 3 power x. So 3 power 4 is 3 power 6 because a power m into a power n will be a power m plus n will be equal to 3 power x. If bases are equal, you can equate the powers. X value is going to be 6. Mark it as option E. Look at the next question, which is available on the screen. What is this value? Will be 4x squared. 4x squared divided by 8x squared. They are asking the value. It is going to be 1 by 2. Mark it as answer. It's going to be 1 by 2. Mark it as answer. Look at the next question. So 5 power k plus 1 is equal to 2000. 5 power k plus 1 is equal to how much? So 5 power k plus 1, 5 power k into 5 power 1 will be equal to 2000. From this, what is 5 power k value? 5 power k value will be 5400. So 5 power k plus 1 is the required quantity, that is 401. Mark it as option B. 401, mark it as option B. Look at the next question available. This is equal to 5 power 8. So 5 power 7 minus of minus 4, that is equal to 5 power 8, that is A value will be equal to 11. So from this data, 2 power minus 3 plus 2 will be equal to 2 power B. What is B value? B value is minus 1. So here, this is 3 power 9 is equal to 3 power 6, C value is equal to 9. They are asking us to find out what is A plus B plus C. A plus C is 20, 20 minus 1. A plus B plus C, they are asking. So 20 minus 1, 19, you can mark it as answer. Basically, question which is related. So if you observe, this is equal to some numerator divided by A minus B into A minus A plus B. So A square minus B square, that is 5 minus 3, that will be 2. Denominator is 2. Numerator is 2 square plus 2 square plus 2 cube plus 2 power 4. So if you can take out 2 as a common factor on the numerator, you can write as 2 power 1 plus 2 power 1 plus 2 power 2 plus 2 power 3. Denominator, it is going to be 2. It will be gets cancelled. So 2 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 should be the answer. 10 plus 6 is going to be 16. Mark it as option B. Look at the next question. So question is a product of these numbers. It will be x power 2 by 3. It will be x power 5 by 4. So a power m into a power n. So a power m plus 1. So x power 2 by 3 plus 5 by 4. You can take the LCM of these numbers. That's going to be 12. 4 to the 8. 4 to the 12. 5 to the 15. So x power 23 divided by 12. How can we take it? 12th root of x power 23, which is available as option E. You can mark it as answer. So that's how we can able to see all the questions which are related to algebra. That's your algebra topic. Thank you so much. See you in the next session.